Welcome back. As I told in the previous video, we are going to write a program using mouse events. Let us see how this can be written. So I'll start from the output screen. This is a thing you'll be getting something like this. When the moment you press mouse button, you'll be getting a message on the screen like down. And if you move the mouse, what is the x and y coordinate? And this is what I'm talking about, the applet. So what is the size of this applet viewer? You have to fix it. And let us see how this can be done. So I told if it is event driven, if your Java program is event driven, you have to import java.awt.star. Dot star indicates which is going to, you're going to import all the classes in the AWT package. Next we have aw.event. We are going to import this. We are going to import a package called applet. Look at this part. We have applet called mouse event. So this is not your Java program. Please look at this. I repeat, this part is not your Java program. So this is not part of your Java. We have put this in a comment, but still when you run this, you'll be getting the screen, output screen. So this is going to give you the output screen, what is the width and height for this, and you'll have a message called mouse event. This is a code for this, with the heading for this. So this is separate your output screen. And look at your class called mouse event. Look at the beautiful things which, what it does, which is going to extend applet. Because in this case, I know, as I told in the previous video, for every event we need to have two things. One is your source, other one is listener. If you take your program now, for this the source as well as listener is your applet, nobody else. Your applet is going to be the source, your applet is going to be your listener. So for this purpose, we are going to extend applet. Applet is a superclass, and implement mouse listener and mouse motion listener. What are these? These are the listener interfaces. We are making use of mouse thing. So we have implemented two classes. And if you look at mouse listener, as I told in the previous video, we have got five methods. All the methods in the mouse listener has to be implemented. And we have another interface called mouse motion listener, which has got two more methods. And so this is a variable called message, which is of type string. We have another two integer variable, mouse x. So initially it is coordinator, coordinates value is zero. Init, normally every applet start with init. Init is something but initialization. And what it does is, so I told every source has to register with the listener. We have studied this. So this is syntax for this. Add mouse listener. So this is the listener for my source. Applet is going to say that, so when I create an event, so your my mouse is going to listen this. What are the listeners? So add mouse listener and add mouse motion listener. These are my listeners. So look at this statement. This is the way we add the listener for the event. And what is interfaces? Interface is nothing but mouse listener and mouse motion listeners. So don't get confused. So this is the way we add listener to the event, these two statement, and this is the way we deal with the what do you call it, events. Now look at this. What are the methods your mouse listener has got? It has got five methods. One is mouse clicked. So we are going to take it as initially it is 0 and 10. We are going to print a message mouse click, and we have something called repaint. Repaint is something like, which is going to call a method called paint in the applet. So please remember that paint is something but we are entering the window. We cannot call it directly. Your JVM is going to call it. So your program start with the init method. Init is the one which is going to initialize everything, which is going to set your listeners. And you have a method called mouse clicked. So this is inside mouse listener interface. So I'm going to implement mouse clicked, mouse entered. I'm going to implement mouse exited. I'm going to implement mouse pressed, and I'm going to implement mouse released. So these are the five methods my interface has got. So every time what it does, when mouse is released, now you're going to print a message called up. And look at this, my next message, which is, you know, and after every method, what I do is repaint. So please remember this, using, we have no access to call the paint method. There is a method called paint, I'll let you know. Yeah, this is a paint method. It's a paint method. We have no access to call this method. We cannot call this directly. So whenever I want to make some changes in the update window, in the output screen, I can call a method called repaint. So please remember that your repaint calls the paint method. Paint is called by the Java virtual machine. So please remember this. And so for every, whenever I, there is a message I want to print on the screen, I'll call repaint. So look at this, all my methods have a repaint method. See the previous page also, I have a repaint method. See, repaint, repaint calls, I repeat, repaint calls my paint method. Next. Yeah. So this is another method called mouse moved. So which is going to, what you call, this method called show status, moving mouse at what is the coordinate, in which places you are going to move it. And look at the next statement, we have a method called paint graphics g, g dot draw string message mouse x mouse y. So this is going to be done whenever a method is called. So whenever a method calls repaint method, it will come to the paint method. So we have got five methods, all these five methods, everyone is going to call this paint method. Whenever mouse is pressed, whenever mouse is released, whenever we exit from the screen, whenever we enter the screen, all these cases, what happened is we are going to call this paint method. Paint is a method which is having access to this update screen. So which is going to give what is the x coordinate and y coordinate, which is going to give you the things. So as you could see in this, so mouse event class extends applet and implements two interfaces. One is mouse listener, other one is mouse motion listener interface. These two interfaces contain method that receives and processes the various types of mouse events. This is simple as this. And what is another feature of this program? If you look at this program, nowhere we have public static method. Public static method is, I used to say that, no, there is an entry point, your Java program start there. But if you look at this program, we don't have this. You know why? Because this is not your Java program, this is an applet program, applets. Applet does not have the main method. So I hope you understood this. So I repeat, your program starts with, this is going to give you the applet window. Init is the method which is going to initialize the applet, or which is going to register the listeners. And if you take this program, your applet, your container is the source as well as the listener. So every source has to register with the listener. So this is a place we are going to register it. And these are the methods which is going to handle different mouse events, like mouse click, mouse entered, mouse exited, mouse pressed, and we have mouse released. We have two more methods which is to deal with whenever a mouse is dragged and mouse is moved. And base entry point for this program. So this is the entry point. After initialization, it will come to the paint method. Paint, we need not call explicitly. This will be called by your Java virtual machines. And there is another way of calling paint. We can do it. But who is going to do it? Your repaint can call this paint method. Please take care of this. Repaint can call this paint method. Two ways by which we can call paint. One is your JVM, Java virtual machine does it. Second one is your repaint is going to call this. So this is all about the program. What do you call, how we deal with the mouse events. So the program demonstrate mouse event handlers. We have another program, the next one, which is going to deal about, which is going to deal with, you know, your keyboard event handlers. These two programs are very important. I repeat everyone to go through this. And as far as your exams are concerned, we can expect one out of these two. Either mouse event handling program or the other one, keyboard event handling. So please go through this. If you have any doubt, please feel free to contact me. Thank you. Have a nice day.